what are the indicators suggesting about public investment? I think the April to June fiscal data was reasonably encouraging in terms of just the spending side. I think CapEx was reasonably high compared to previous quarters.
I think it's very encouraging that the government, is determined to push public investment through. We saw at the central level, as I mentioned earlier, from October to March, CapEx grew by 75%. Both the central and state budgets have 30% growth in capital expenditure this year. I think 30-35% growth. So all we need to happen is for those budgets to be executed. No one's asking for new fiscal resources to be found and more public investment to be done. Just those budget plans need to be executed. As you said, April to June, revenue expenditure net of interest contracted 7%. But the central government plowed through with the CapEx, which grew almost 25%. So that's really encouraging. And to the extent that, we may see some positive surprises on the revenue side, that hopefully will not impinge on these CapEx plans later in the year. I think what's important to monitor is whether the states can carry on, can actually execute on the high CapEx plans that they've budgeted. I think the center seems to be on that track for sure. In the case of states, very often this CapEx gets cut in the last 6 months or 3 months. And this year, as we've discussed before, the state deficits are already below the 4% that they should be targeting under the glide path. And in fact, even after that, their borrowing number for the first 5 months of this year is 15 to 20% below last year and below what they've budgeted for this year. So we don't want a situation where states become too conservative, overdo the fiscal consolidation, and public investment gets cannibalized. I think the center will do well to nudge states to say, it's okay to borrow a little bit more if in fact that borrowing is going towards fructifying your public investment plans. I can't state enough that when you have a consumption slowdown, it's the job creation and the income certainty that that provides that will help. And so doing this infrastructure spending will create jobs, can hopefully crowd in private investment, and also boosts, as we'll discuss, total factor productivity.